place. There are many ways in Build-A-Boat to make money. I mean, you can make yourself a car. You can make yourself a grinder, a gold grinder. You can even make yourself an AFK gold grinder. But guys, today we are going to be talking about probably one of the least known ways of making an AFK farm in Build-A-Boat, or at least just making gold in Build-A-Boat. And that is by stabbing people. Yes, you want to make some money? Let's stab some people. That's right, Chill Thrill. That's what Chill Thrill thought when he made this. Guys, today we are here with my very good friend Ralph. And my friend Ralph here reminded me and showed me this incredible mass murder AFK farm in Build-A-Boat. AFK farm and Build-A-Boat. Guys, it's not just any kind of farm. It's actually really good for starting players because it's super easy to set up. And as you guys can see, I am now consistently making money by literally killing people. As you look at the bottom right, can we get an examination? Can we enhance?
Oh,
it looks like we're making money, which means that we've successfully got ourselves a gold farm here. Now, as you guys can see, there's a lot of people dying. These are like all of our alt accounts. Like, for example, there's this guy. Hey, look at this guy. Look what a nice guy he is. Well, he is about to die any second now. Yeah, he's taking damage. Now, this man is called to sub to Ralph or Dumb Moron. That's his name. He's a very nice guy. I'll put him away again for a second. Now, guys, actually setting up this farm is literally dirt cheap. I think you probably only need like a couple hundred blocks, especially if you have the skill tool. So it's like super easy to set up. Like it's pretty crazy. Now, Ralph, are you here? I think he's here. Ralph?
Yep. Yep, I am.
My friend Ralph, he's been off YouTube for a little minute. But
yeah,
I've heard from the grapevine that you have returned on the channel, right?
Yeah, I've been starting YouTube again.
This is an OG Build-A-Boat YouTuber right here. This guy has been around the block. He's been away for a little while, but he's back and he's going to be posting. And I highly recommend you check out his channel. I will leave a link down there in the description. There's going to be many farms like this one and all kinds of other cool stuff. Cool. Like you do like cool mechanic stuff, right? You love to do mechanics.
Yeah. Glitches, build glitches, everything around that
I will
area.
Recommend watching it because I will be watching it. And if you're as smart as I am, you will also be watching it. Now, here, if you guys can see, I'm currently just sat. Oh, wait. Ah, I think I messed it up. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Oh, no, man.
Do you need candy, the pink candy, to help you out?
I'll be okay. I got this, okay? I'll do a strat.
It's gonna be really difficult.
I got this. Oh my god.
Try to maybe lean on the wall and then... Yeah. Oh, you almost got it.
I got this. I can get back to the chair. Pretty much, I'm just sitting here in a chair with a sword in my hand, automatically killing people. And guys, okay, here. Let's actually do some math here, okay? So every single kill earns you 3 gold, which might not sound like a lot of gold, okay? 3 gold, you hear 3 gold, and you might think to yourself, I can't even buy anything with 3 gold. Okay, so let's actually do some math here. I have a second phone. I have my other phone right here running the game, automatically dying. Now I'll grab my other phone, this one right here. Let's do some math here, okay? Let's get a timer up and running, okay? Let's pile some people up here for a second, and then we will start a timer. We're gonna see how much money you can actually make with this if you did this like all night long. So guys, 3, 2, 1, start, okay? We're running the timer. I'm keeping it in the screen so that way nobody thinks I'm cheating, okay? There's no cheating happening here. Wait, actually, wait. I made a big mistake. I forgot to see how much gold we had before we started. All right, give me 1 second, guys. Okay, I gotta count the amount of people that I'm killing here. Okay, so 3, 2, 1, start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We've killed 6 people by now. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 people. All right, let's say 13 people in 30 seconds. Look at the clock. It says, well, it says 32 because I'm an idiot. I didn't stop it in time. 30 seconds. You kill around 30 people. Okay, let's grab the math. Let's grab the calculator. Think about this for a second, guys. We are talking about some incredible numbers right here, okay? So we got 12 in 30 seconds, right? So 12 times 3 equals this much gold in 30 seconds. Now, let's say we did this for a minute. So we do it times 2. 30 seconds times 2 equals 1 minute. I'm not an idiot. This much per minute. Now, let's go per hour. How much money do you make per hour? Times 60. 60 minutes in 1 hour. Boom. 4,320 gold in an hour. We're starting to talk about some interesting numbers here, brother. Now, let's say we take this number and do it times 24. There's 24 hours in 1 day. What if you did this for 1 day? How much money would you have in the bank? You cannot tell me that you right now have that amount of money in the bank. If you built this AFK farm and you just did this for 24 hours, you would have this number in your bank account. Well, not your real bank account. I'm not a scam. Your Build-A-Boat bank account. Now, I've currently got 593,000 gold in my bank. Pretty good. That's considered like really high. That's considered like very, very, very high. So yeah, I mean, the proof is in the pudding. It's an incredible AFK farm. And it's so cool because like barely anyone actually even talks about this mechanic in Build A Boat. So I hereby also invite you to think of some really, really creative ideas to use killing people in your AFK farms to maybe even bump the amount of money that you're making from any AFK farm to be even higher. Because I think it's possible. So yeah, I think it's about time that I explain to you how you can build yourself one of these farms. Look at all these dead people.
In 5 minutes or less, pretty much. That's how fast it takes you to build it.
It takes about 5 minutes to build. Have you got 5 minutes? I've got 5 minutes. I always have 5 minutes, man. That's so short. Dude, I can make a build farm in 5 minutes. Freaking crazy. All right, Ralph, I'm going to politely request you to clear your blocks. Actually, hey, Ralph.
No.
Yes, I want your money. Dude, this is like just robbing a bunch of people. That's what this really just feels like, doesn't it? All right, I just wanted to make all that money real quick. Okay, now let's actually get to this tutorial because, guys, it is super, super, super easy to build, okay? So I've actually made... Okay, I just want to say this. Is this the one? I think this is the one. No, oh, no, I loaded in the wrong thing. My bad. Now, guys, if you've already in the past built yourself a cheap AFK farm like this one, you can actually recycle this platform by just deleting all that and instead building a thing over here, right? But I'm going to build this from scratch because not everyone has that. So it's only reasonable to build this from scratch, if you know what I'm saying. So yesterday, as we started the tutorial, Adopt Me came out with an update and literally killed Build-A-Boat. It was unplayable. So here we are. Let's get right into the schkaboozle. Yes, I don't know if that's a word. All right, guys, here we go. So what we're going to do is we're going to start off. Actually, I'll open my settings menu so you can see what my settings are. We're going to start off right here. We're going to find the light green corner of the plot. We're going to place ourselves 3 blocks right here. So bim, bam, boom. Okay, just like that. Then what we're going to do is we're going to place ourselves 16 pistons right here. 1, 2, 16. Boom. There you go. Then what we're going to do, guys, we're going to place ourselves another wooden block on the end right there. And we're going to actually zoink this into the wall. So that way it can physically not get unanchored, okay? We want to make sure of this. Because if it does get unanchored, it would be big bad. Then what we're going to do is we're going to place one more block there and then another block. And then we can literally make this as small as we want. It doesn't freaking matter. So I'm going to make it 0.2 blocks thick. So that way it literally costs me practically nothing to make this thing, okay? Like I can make this thing ginormous and it costs like next to nothing. So yeah, going to set my skill tool back to 2. And then what I'm going to do right here is I'm going to scale this part all the way to the other side of the light green like so. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to make this about 90 studs long. Okay. If you look right here, if I skill this, it actually like changes one of the numbers. I'm going to set that to 90. Okay. There you go, brother. Now, guys, if you wanted to just make sure that everything is going okay. Actually, before you do anything, delete those 2 blocks right there. You don't need them anymore. Make a quick save state right here. Bimity bam boom. And then what we can actually do, guys, we can actually test this out to make sure that everything is perfectly up to snuff. There's no faults or anything like that going on. So just place down a chair. And if you push it out, what you want to see, okay, is you want to make sure that all of the actual spawn points are covered. And as you guys can see, they are currently perfectly covered. That's why I told you to do that. And as you also can see, there is currently all the way right here in the corner. The wood is going all the way into the wall, which is also what we want to see, as you guys can see right there. So we've done it perfectly. Now I'm going to reload this thing.
Reload it. Yes.
And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to place a block right here. And I'm just going to scale that out all the way like that. And you can also make this one paper thin. It doesn't matter. So I'm just going to make this super thin, just like that. Nothing too special. As you guys can see, there it is. Now, as we've done that, we have literally finished the platform part of this build. Actually, wait, no. We haven't. There's one more final thing to do. And that is to place the actual chair. Now, guys, what I'm actually going to do right here is I'm going to quickly save this. Yes. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at around about here. And you want to just kind of place it just left of this tree. Kind of, as you can see, there's that little nook right there. Can we get an enhancement, Tom? Right there. You see that right there? Around about there is where you want to place a block. Okay. You want to just scale this out like this. And this is just for visual right now, just to test something out. Okay. We're going to unanchor. And we're going to quickly place ourselves a chair so that way we can actually test this out. We want to make sure that that block right there. Okay. I've got to push it a little bit to the left. It's about exactly in the center of this wall piece right here. You kind of got to eyeball it a little bit. So I want to place this like one block here to the left. As you guys can see, that would make it perfect. Yes. Wait, no. Yes, yes, yes. Okay. One stud to the left there. So yeah, skill this one stud to the left, like so. Bam, bam. And what I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to set my merge level to red. I'm going to place a block on top of there. And then what I'm actually going to do, guys, is I'm going to place myself a bunch of blocks right here, just like so, in one line. So that way we can get the exact right measurement, just like so. And once again, push this all the way out. And as you guys can see, there's going to be one block here that is going to be perfectly right next to the wall, like that. As you guys can see, there it is. So we want to delete every single block that goes behind there. As you can see, we can delete all of these right here. We don't need these. I went a little bit too far, but yeah. Yeah. Delete all those, push everything back together. And then what we're gonna do, guys, is we're actually gonna grab ourselves a chair and we're gonna place this right here, like so, facing this direction, like that, that way, as you guys can see, like that. We can delete all these blocks. We don't need them anymore. And this right here, guys, is our entire platform done. So I'm actually gonna save this. Save, yes. And now all we have left to do is actually make ourselves the device that is gonna like make this a conveyor. Now, guys, if you wanted to know how a conveyor actually works, pretty much any block, if it's moving, while it's moving, if it gets anchored, it will keep that speed and it will move the player at that speed. So for example, if I grab myself a car, I could actually make this the conveyor for the actual farm, because as you guys can see, I can move this. So if I move this and then I anchor it, this is now a conveyor. Obviously, I'm not gonna use this because it's probably like the hardest one I could use. I like how I just exploded everything. So yeah, what I'm actually gonna do for my personal device is I'm gonna make myself, I'm not gonna make myself, I'm gonna use a plane, okay? Plane part is probably the easiest to configure the actual speed of, because it always travels at the exact same speed. So what I'm gonna do right here is I'm gonna set my rotation tool to 45. I'm gonna place myself a butter block like so, and then I'm gonna make myself a little part just like that. Nothing too special, nothing too fancy, okay? Just like that. And I'm gonna place a jet on top of there just like so. Actually, make sure that it's all covered. There you go. So yeah, as I have this right here, I think that is everything done that I needed to get done to be able to go AFK in this farm. So what I'm actually going to do, because it just makes my life a little bit easier, I'm going to make sure to actually place myself in my save slot like this. I'm going to place myself a little sword pack right there, just so that way, no matter what, I can always grab a sword, because you don't want to forget it on accident, obviously. So yeah, I'm going to save this. And that is my AFK farm completed. Yes! So guys, what we're going to actually do to set this all up is we're going to just sit in our chair and we're going to push this all forward like so. Boom. There is that done. And what we're going to do is we're going to walk over to our little chair situation right here. We're going to sit down, actually press our butter block with our property tool. We're going to select this wooden part right here and we're going to activate, and then we're just going to anchor like so. And now what this has done, it has created a conveyor right here, which is exactly what we wanted. And we can delete all this junk from there. And then we just, all we need to do is scale this part into the other part just like so. And what that should have done, it should have made that entire piece right there also, you know, move like that. And what we're going to do is we're going to select this part right here and we're going to anchor it. And with that, we should have officially created our killing AFK farm. Look, I respawn. Oh my god, I'm going to die. Haha. So yeah, now I just sit here with my sword and I just slice away. Life is good, slicing away, doing what I love to do, which is, you know, slice people. Now, guys, you can actually experiment a little bit if you want to with the different directions to put the conveyor into. Like, you know, because the more you're going to make more money, the quicker you can actually kill people. But what I've currently done, as you can kind of see, I'm currently spawning and I'm ending up right here. So that's actually not that good. So you might actually want to make... You might actually want to make the plane go straight. But yeah, it's just fun to kind of play around with those different properties and kind of get an idea for like how to make the absolute best one. I would really love to see you guys get creative with this and, you know, see if you can make some cool designs. Post it on the subreddit. Love to see them. So yeah, what I'm going to do right here is I'm actually going to rotate the plane before I activate it. Push this over. All right, let's get this thing set up, baby. Oh, pretty much straight. Doesn't have to be exact. Activate anchor. Scale it in there. Anchor that. And I think that that is that done. So now, no matter where we spawn, we should get whooshed into the wall.
Oh my god, I'm stuck. Oh no, I'm gonna get
killed by the man that's sitting here, which is gonna be me making all this money. But guys, that is how you make yourself a working AFK kill farm. Boys, please share your designs with me. I'd love to see them. Make sure to check out Ralph. There is gonna be a link in the description to his channel. He's an awesome guy. And I'll see you all in the next video, boys. Peace out, everyone. And bye, man.